This is the job I was born to do.
This is how the oysters want to grow if you don't separate them. And this oyster orgy may just look obscene, but this is just nature, you know? This is how they do it. It's beautiful, really. All that oyster spawning.
Welcome to American Beauty, the series that explores the roots of American identity, the independence, creativity, and resilience that can be found throughout the country. At this stop, we're heading to Seattle, Washington, a seaport city primarily known for its major coffee companies and for being the birthplace of grunge music. But being an oceanic town also makes it uniquely suited to another major industry, oyster farming. I decided to stop into one of the city's most famous oyster spots to get an education on the delicacy that's defined by its regional flavor. More than four decades old, Elliott's Oyster House is a staple in Seattle's culinary scene. Here, customers visit year-round to sample dozens of oyster varieties. So I met with executive chef Robert Spaulding to learn what makes this regional industry boom.
What sets Seattle oysters apart from oysters that you might get in other parts of the country?
Seattle is centrally located in the Salish Sea.
Okay.
There are glaciers that run water down the rivers into the bays, so there's lots of mineral content.
Is there a distinct flavor to the oysters in this area?
I would say yes. Notes of melon and cucumber.
Why do you think the demand for oysters is increasing?
People are looking for a connection, a direct, visceral connection to nature.
So what are the chances that we can try some right now?
Let's do it.
Oh, damn.
So here we
have them. You're not messing around with this oyster tray. Which one do I start with?
Let me shuck you a hamahama here.
Wow. I feel like I'm like out on a kayak with like salt spray in my face, and it's just like, it's amazing.
At Elliott's, I had a meal fit for a king, but it was the incredible diversity in the oysters that piqued my interest as to where they all came from. So I took a trip outside of town to the Olympic Peninsula to explore an actual oyster farm. The Hamahama Oyster Company is a near century old business, and to this day, it's still family run. I was met by sales manager Justin Stang to take a brief tour of the processing plant and to see the harvested product before it hits the dish.
How much are you kind of equipped to process here on like any given day?
You know, basically with the crew we have out picking the oysters and then boxing the oysters, you know, we can do 1,500, 2,000 dozen in one day.
Oh, wow.
No problem at all, yeah.
So what's going on here today?
Yep, these are the oysters. Each bag color represents a different either size or variety of oyster.
All right.
So the crew can easily identify this oyster is from this beach or this oyster is from that beach or it's a different size.
You still do everything like by hand?
Yeah, you know, oyster harvesting in the last few thousand years, just like oyster opening, there are various like mechanical improvements, but for the most part, pretty much the same way, you know, our great-great-grandparents did it.
It wasn't going to be much help at the plant, but I was assured that I'd be put to work during my stay. So I got some rest before waking up in the dead of the night to meet Adam James, a fifth generation family member at Hamahama and one of the company's main oyster farmers.
And here we are.
We strapped on our headlamps and trudged out into the night to get our hands dirty during the low tide.
So while some people are like closing down the bars, you're out here bending over, doing backbreaking work.
Like you just can't start late, you know what I mean? Like the tide doesn't wait.
I'm just building up a crazy appetite for oysters out here.
Here you go, buddy.
Nice.
First one of the night, or the season.
Oh, man. That's probably the best oyster I've ever had.
So this is where we grow the blue pool oysters.
Okay.
Oh, you got the basket, you're good, okay.
I don't go anywhere without my basket.
You don't go anywhere without your basket. It's a little moon snail.
Wow.
Yep. These guys eat a lot of clams.
Can you eat that?
I wouldn't recommend it. These are our tumbled oysters. So as the tide comes in, you know, the buoy flips up like that. And then you can just start unclipping bags.
The idea is we're taking these bags in?
No, we're gonna come get them tomorrow.
Oh, so once these are unclipped, they'll float up with the high tide.
Exactly.
And then they'll just come out and they'll just be...
They're gonna float up, and then we'll just unclip them.
Once we had prepped the oysters, we trekked back to get some shut-eye before meeting again on the barge to collect our harvest.
What
let's step down off here and roll these cages off. And make sure you don't get a bobber line wrapped around your foot. So with these guys, put the bobber line like this and then just give it a little chug. It's good. I'll let you get the next one.
All right.
There you go.
Just bobber line out of the way.
Yeah, bobber line's out of the way. You can just give it a roll. Oh, watch yourself.
Whoa, there it is.
We're good. Go for it. Oh, yeah.
Yeah!
Nice.
Tomorrow those will be filled with oysters. So Hamahama started as a logging company.
Yeah, as a logging company, and then the Depression hit, and times got tough.
And my grandpa was, you know, in the aftermath of that, trying to figure out a way to make the farm pay for itself, basically. And the oysters were just kind of out there. They'd naturalized. People brought the oysters in from Japan, the Pacific oyster. They'd just started appearing on the beach.
Our grandfather really put his shoulder behind developing a year-round go-to sort of Pacific oyster operation. Do these oysters look familiar?
These are the ones that we bagged last night, right?
Yep, exactly. So these are gonna come in for sorting. So have you ever ran hydraulics before?
No, it's my first time.
That's great. Go ahead and get a feel for that. That's the easiest one to run. So nice and slow. So this is the main boom, like playing video games, right? So boom down, boom up.
This is the oyster feast right here. I'm getting a nice little shower of
saltwater shower.
Yeah.
Our family here has, you know, it quickly became sort of a love affair with this spot.
You know, we like to think we're like, our business is about place first and foremost. So it's like whatever this place wants us to do, but we're always wondering like what's gonna be next. You know, like what can we do with this place that will help us into the next 100 years?
So you could be potentially like the last generation of real old school oyster farmers.
Possibly.
So if your parents didn't push you to choose to be an oyster farmer, you decided to do it on your own. So why?
Because I love oysters.
It's been awesome seeing the hard work that goes into getting these oysters onto the tray, but now I'm just ready to eat them.
Having spent just one full day working as an oyster farmer, I was exhausted, but the payoff is worth it. Lissa, Adam, and the rest of the Hamahama family are incredibly dedicated to their craft. It's that same perseverance and spirit across the country that's truly at the heart of American beauty.